Oh yeah, on another note, one of my Sawyer bags finally burst after 770 miles. It got creased on the bottom and it finally like sprung a little leak, and then as I was using it one last time, one of the seams on the side sprung a little leak. But most of the water was still going in my bottle through the filter. The terrible part, I bought 3 new bags at Trail Days. They're at home. Because I wanted to squeeze some last miles out of this one. Just see how far they would go. And well, I figured it out. So that is the bag I've been using the most, because I had 2 bags and I would just keep like one put away in my pack until I got to camp, and the other one would be my day-to-day filter bag. So 700 miles filtering every day is pretty good. So I'm getting the new bags mailed to me at Waynesboro, so it's not a big deal because I plan on getting them there anyway. But if they're not, I'll just have to stop in at the outfitter and pick up platypus bags or some more Sawyer bags, whatever they have. Anyway, that was something I forgot. I'll just a little boulder field, eh? I ended up staying in the shelter last night too, which I know I got my new tent, but we're down like a creek bottom ravine thing, and if I set my tent up, no matter what, even double walled tents down here would have condensated. It just wasn't worth it for me. Especially when there's open space and shelter. So, but using the tent tonight again. So far I've been very happy with it. Yeah. For about a mile, I get to walk along the James River. Can't really see it that well. Tons of trees in the way. But still a nice little view. It's different than the, fog and stuff that I've been seeing the last 2 days. Which it looks like it might have cleared out today. I guess we'll see when we get up top on the mountains. So, here we are. The James River Footbridge. Let's see if I can do this. You know what, I'm just gonna flip the camera around. Too much work. So, here we are. The James River Footbridge. Let's see if I can do this. You know what, I'm just gonna flip the camera around. Too much work. Just did some trail magic. North end of the James River Footbridge. I got a Powerade. And I got a donut. And a pudding cup. Oh, look. Route 812's right here. And I got a pecan sweet roll. Pecan roll. Starting to drizzle. Just a little bitty. So if I get up in the woods, it won't be bad. And here's where the trail goes back in the woods. Nice little creek right here. Runs into the James River. Anyway, on I go. Well, this footbridge is just north of the 812 crossing right there, north of the James River. That's the creek I was just talking about. Nice spot. The bridge is a little slick though. That's okay. Anyway, I'm gonna get up to the next shelter. Camel up. And then keep going. Just climbed up out of John's Hollow shelter. Little Rocky Row Mountain right here. Supposed to be a good view. As you can tell, it's foggy again. Oh well. Maybe one of these days, it won't be foggy. This is the top of Big Bluff Mountain. For the Powell family. He may be related to you. You guys ought to look it up, see, you know, if there's any relation. Looks like there was a fire tower up here at one point. Or power line. Well, the steps is probably a fire tower. Whew. Not really much from the way of views today. Oh well. This right here is a sign for Punch Bowl Shelter. It was my planned stop tonight. I've made up enough miles that I'm a half day early. Yes, because it's only 12:30. So I'm going to try and keep going. And then I'll kind of wing it. Still planning on resupplying tomorrow. So I'll probably double up my meal again tonight. Maybe I can get some more calories down. Because I know I'm losing weight. And I don't want to lose weight because I don't need to. This is Punch Bowl Mountain Overlook. The AT, that's southbound. It came out over there and it'll come in right here. As you can see, there's a garbage can, so I dropped my garbage. Just got hooked up with some trail magic. The same couple that dropped me off, or they gave me a ride to the trail 2 days ago. I just missed them by like 10 minutes yesterday when I went right before Hickok Knob. They're slack packing a couple friends of theirs. But they gave me a Mountain Dew, bag of chips, and some Oreos. Nice little extra boost for the day. And now I'm just doing extra miles today. They're trying to go all the way into the two people are slack packing. I'm just trying to do more miles. I don't know what they're trying to do. But I might catch them. We'll see. But the couple, I'm sorry if If you guys see my video, I forgot your names. I'm so sorry. But what do we got here? I'm supposed to see water just north on the trail. Because I need water. I just put down my last, I put down half a liter just now at lunch, which with the trail magic. I was gonna stop there anyway, but I put down half a liter and I've got my, I got a Powerade that I was given this morning. So I've got enough. I'd like to, you know, fill up on water. Anyway, off I go. On another good note, it's clearing up. It's not foggy down here. And I hear the water, so that's good. But anyway, it's not foggy. I'm starting to get some better views. Hopefully it stays this way. I hear water, so I'm gonna find it. Trail's in front of me. Up there, it looks like it goes up. So I'm gonna find this water real quick and go get some. Finally starting to get some views again. This is looking back towards Punch Bowl Shelter, but I don't exactly know where it is. Not really sure, but it's nice to get some views again, even though it is starting to warm up now that the sun's out and the fog's, you know, breaking away. But it's a trade-off I'll have to make sometimes. Pretty neat. You got the sun, and then you got this. People, it's just frustrating. That's just so frustrating. Reservoir Road. Mile 799.3. That means I'm 7/10 away from breaking 800. Oh, look. The bridge over the Peddler River. A suspension bridge. What? Oh, my knees are sore. Oh, this is a cool river. Just smells like there's fish in here. You can hear like a waterfall flowing into it. Oh, I can see fish. It's not very deep. It's only like 3 foot deep where I am, or where I can see the deepest. Anyway. Well, I don't think this is actually 800. I think it's a little short, but I'm not upset. 800 miles. Woohoo! Day 63. I hit 800 miles. I'm tired. I'm looking forward to getting to the shelter area, eating, sitting in my tent, starting to read some more, and relaxing. I'll try and buy some more Sawyer bags when I get to Buena Vista, if the outfitter or if the hostel has some. Maybe I get lucky and find one in a hiker box. That's still good. Like where somebody replaced their filter or something and threw the bag away. Hey. Oh, a squirrel just broke a branch. Maybe I'll get one in Waynesboro. Because mine did not get sent in my package. Because I forgot to tell the family that I needed one. Now it's too late to send the package out. But that's okay. I'm not upset. They're only like $9 for a 3-pack. And it can't hurt to have extras at home either. I'll probably throw away the one that busted. Ow. And then the 3 that I buy, if they sell the 3-pack, then I'll keep 2, mail one home. Anyway, this is a nice area. All these pine needles are good for on the ground for camping on. They don't pick up on the bottom of your tent. They keep the mud and the water down. They insulate a little bit, make it a nice soft bed. Ooh. Well, anyway, I'm gonna keep pushing to the shelter. I have no idea what reservoir this is. I mean, there's kayakers, like a fishing kayak. And I see a small boat off in the distance. See, kind of hard to see, but you can definitely see. There's a kayak on the left and a small boat on the right. I have no idea. I guess I'll Google Maps it real quick. If I had to guess, because that was the Peddler River and Reservoir Road we just crossed, we being metaphorically me, I would say this is the Peddler Reservoir. But I don't know. I could be wrong. Been wrong before. Which, you know, I'd like to camp down there. But whatever. I'll probably be climbing the mountains away from it. Yeah. I'm already starting to drift away. Unless the trail stays like on this ridge side. This is Swapping Camp Road, 802.3, I believe. And the trail south of here, for like the last two tenths of a mile, is just a muddy mess. I really hope the trail north of here isn't. Like, it's hard to see, but all this, it's bad. You can kind of see it on my shoes. It's just a sloppy mess. Something I don't need today. But the good news is I only have like a little bit left to go to the shelter area. And it looks like the trail here is a muddy mess too. Oh well. This is Brown Mountain Creek. And here's the footbridge. Oh. I'm almost to the shelter. It's just up the hill a ways. Not a bad little spot. Oh, I'm tired. So, I'm gonna push on up to the shelter, slowly but surely. I get to walk next to it for a little bit too. So walking along Brown Creek, there used to be a community here of freed slaves. And if you look, you can see an old stone wall. They lived down here. Not gonna lie, not a bad spot to live. You can really see the wall now. Well, now the tree's in the way. There we go. Stupid trekking poles. But yeah, there is the wall. Some more views of the stone wall. Not really much left. But you can still see where it was. And two slack packers up ahead of me. I've already caught them once. And then I stopped to do some videoing and stuff. I'll catch them again here in a minute. Another crossing on Brown Mountain Creek. And I just did my part, cleaning up the AT. Saw a bear rope stuck in the tree. It's just a cheap rope. Like some Walmart cord. I mean, nothing against it, just doesn't work that well for bear rope. But anyway, I got it out. I'll probably give it to somebody in the shelter when I get there. Ugh. There's a nice little camping area over there. I should be coming to the shelter. Yeah, I can see the privy right up there. So realistically, I'm done for the day, and it's not even 4 o'clock, I think. Woohoo! I got time to relax tonight. So, I enjoy reading the logbook sometimes, because you get gems like this. Well, I'm gonna relax for a little bit before I set my tent up. And I gotta find a decent spot. I think I might go over there, it might be a flat spot. Otherwise, I'll have to cross the creek again to where I found that rope. Oh well. It's day 64. And it's a resupply day. Which means I get to go into a town. I'm going into Buena Vista. via Hog Camp Gap. It's like a 1.5 mile walk downhill. Supposedly they shuttle you back. Let's hope they do. It's like 8 miles for me this morning. So I left Matt's Creek, or no, that was yesterday. I left Brown Mountain Creek Shelter. It's like just after 7:30. I left a little before 7:30. It's like an 8 mile walk, eight and change or something. So, pack's pretty light. I only got like a couple snacks and one dinner left in it. But I do have like a 4 mile uphill walk to get to it. So there's that. Met another guy last night who watched my videos until he started the trail this year. Trail name this year is Zach Galifianakis. He does look like him. Let's see. I'm starting to climb. It's like 3,000 feet, 2,000 something, I don't know. But it's like 4 miles up. I'll cross US 60 here in a little bit. And yeah. Hog Camp Gap today. That's where I'm headed to resupply, and then I don't know after that. Because I'm ahead on my schedule. So I was supposed to hit Hog Camp Gap tonight. And go and do like a late afternoon, early evening resupply. I don't know. This puts me hitting Waynesboro instead of early Monday morning, because I would have camped just out like 5 miles out. This puts me there Sunday night. So hopefully I can just push out, get in there Sunday night. Hopefully there's still a space left in the hostel. Because it's like the Free Church hostel. There's like room for 20 people, but oh boy, we're coming up on a historical sign marker, and you can see the stone wall over there. Ow, almost fell. My feet are sore. Alright, time to read the marker. It's basically the same marker, just different point of view as the last one. Well, I'm about to start climbing, so my hands are getting cold because it's still like mid-50s in the morning. But it looks like the sun might be out today. So that'll be a blessing and a curse. Oh look, more stones stacked. Anyway, off I go. So here we are at the US 60 crossing. The AT comes out right over there by the fugitive and Zach Galifianakis. And then I don't get hit by a car, it goes back in over here somewhere. This is Long Mountain Wayside. Little picnic area. Apparently, Virginia 686 is this way. I don't really know where the trail is over here. But it should be right up here on the left. And I'm like a third of the way up the mountain this morning. Looks like there's some construction over there. Haha, here it is. I know the AT will cross that dirt road further up, about halfway up the mountain. So, what do we got? Buena Vista. Oh, come on. A glare. Ugh. Oh well. Anyway, more climbing to do. This is the dirt road about halfway up. Halfway done. Climbing up Bald Knob Mountain, which is not actually bald, but I finally get a view. Oh, there's like radio towers or something over there. Pretty sure the James River Valley's the next set of mountains, because there's a bunch of fog in it. If I can zoom in. Yep, just behind that set right there. That'd be my guess. Anyway, I gotta get resupplied, so I'm gonna keep going. And it's supposed to rain like a downpour at like 6 tonight. So I want to get as far as I can camp set up and everything done by 5:30 at the latest. Because I really don't want to get wet. Just got a little bit further to go to get the Bald Knob, I think. Well, there's the Bald I just came over. Well, this is on top of Coal Mountain. And there's the survey. Yeah. That's a pretty good view. Behind me, there's not much view. You can still see some stuff. Getting closer to the Shenandoahs. Another good view just north of Coal Mountain. This whole grassy meadow on top thing's kind of nice. Now I just gotta find Hog Camp Gap so I can get down and resupply. Dropping down to Hog Camp Gap and, you know, the trail's built up pretty nice. There's also this stone wall that you're walking along. Well, we're coming out on Hog Camp Gap. And I gotta figure out where the hostel is direction.
I think it's the left.
So, like I was saying, trail comes out right here. There's the AT. There's a nice fence. Deserves a picture. And then it goes back in right here at this fence stuff. And you cut across Hog Camp Gap right here. But the hostel is a mile and a half downhill. So, here I go. It's a shame I need a resupply. because it's a mile and a half. But, oh well. So to get to Three Springs Hostel, you take a left down that fire, well, the Forest Service Road, and you come out at this mile and a half downhill mailbox right there, and right at the hill is the hostel. Prices were reasonable. Yeah, prices were reasonable. For like food resupply. $1.50 for potatoes, $1.50 for Spam. It's not a Dollar General. I understand they gotta make, you know, money. But it was $50 for a bunk room. I think there's 6 bunks in there. But it's a really nice, like, you know, bunk room. It's just expensive. And a mile and a half off trail. So now I gotta walk a mile and a half back uphill. And just get as far as I can before the rain comes in tonight. But anyway, hopefully somebody will come along and heading towards the trailhead, I can get a hitch. I didn't bother to ask for a shuttle because I knew it was just going to be expensive. But whatever. It's only another 3 miles a day total. This is Tar Jacket Ridge. And over there, that's what I came over today. That was the bald thing that wasn't really bald. Not bad views. But you can see it's starting to get cloudier and the sky's a little darker. And it's only just afternoon. So, I gotta keep pushing. Try to make it to a nice camp spot before it starts to rain on me. I almost fell. Alright, so anyway. Mile 816.3 is Lovington Spring Trail to the west. And then there's like a little road there. And it's not in the AWOL book. It might be on Guthook's app. But about maybe a tenth, maybe 2/10 at most. There's a spring just north of that. No guarantees on it being there year round. But it looked pretty well traveled. So I got water there, but it just rained 2 days ago. And it was real foggy and stuff yesterday. There was a little bit of rain yesterday. So, yeah. Just doing to the Sealy Woolworth shelter today. It was being like 42 miles. Yeah, 42 miles to Waynesboro for Saturday and Sunday. Not bad. Though tomorrow is gonna be the priest and the climb out of the priest. So, there's that. I don't mind getting into Waynesboro late or camping just before. And then hitching it in the morning, which is probably what'll happen. That'll be Monday. Who knows, I may get some extra miles done tomorrow, depending on how the climb is. The pack feels pretty good after the whole resupply. It's only 2 days. Plus, you know, today's food. I got an extra pack of Pop-Tarts for breakfast on Monday. So I'll get into town. That's really it. Just trying to get to the shelter somewhat early today. get my tent set up so I can have it set up before it all rains. Well, the sky looks good right now. And there'll probably be room in the shelter with me getting there this early. But, new tent. I want to see how it does in a thunderstorm. Well, heavy rain. So, anyway, like 3-something to go. It's like 1 o'clock. Shouldn't be too late of a day. I might keep going. Probably not, though. Because it's nice to eat where there's picnic tables. Have somewhere to sit. I don't know. We'll see when I get to the shelter how the tenting areas are. Yep. Here we are at the Piney River North Fork. And, I gotta step across some rocks. Cause I don't wanna get wet. I wouldn't call it a river. I may be wrong where I am, but I'm pretty sure this is it. There's some camp spots. It's pretty good camping, actually. Tons of flat open space. Lots of big rocks to shield you from the wind. It's not too windy down here either. Tons of tree cover. And now I gotta start climbing uphill some to get to the shelter. Not a bad little camp spot. Old roadbed. It's almost 2 o'clock. I'm taking my time. I'm in no hurry. Really, you know, my schedule was Hog Camp Gap or whatever. Yeah, Hog Camp Gap. So, these are all just extra miles today. Well, I made it to the Sealy Woolworth shelter, like 2:30. And after taking like a 40-minute break, some ibuprofen, putting some food down, I decided to push onto the priest. A couple of the guys rolled in and said, that, you know, they checked the weather and it's not supposed to start till like 8. It was 3:13 when I left, 3:10. 6.6 miles. About three hours of hiking. So, hopefully I'll make it and the rain's actually pushed back to 8 o'clock before it starts coming down. I don't mind tenting in it. I should like to be at a shelter where I can roll up everything dry tomorrow. And the more miles I do today, the less I have to do tomorrow. Because I'm trying to get to Waynesboro either late Sunday night or early Monday morning. If I get there Sunday night, I'll take a zero Monday. I got Tuesday. If I get there Monday, it'll be a Nero in. Which either one's fine. So I'm not planning on hitting the Shenandoahs until Tuesday morning. Just because I want to rest, make sure all my gear is going to work out. And I want to bulk up on the food in town. There's a Chinese buffet that's like all you can eat lunch and dinner. I'm going to hit that up. There's also an Arby's, McDonald's, and Wendy's. I've been craving some McDonald's. I usually get like Big Macs when I go. Ugh, arm's tired. I usually get like Big Macs when I go. I get home, but out here it's been dollar menu. I eat like 6 McDoubles, you know, 6 cheeseburgers or something off the dollar menu, and just drink water. Sometimes I'll just, oh, there was a rock there. Almost went down hard. That's what I get for paying attention to the camera, looking around. not glancing back down at the trail every once in a while. But anyway, before I was really interrupted by that rock. Oh yeah, McDonald's. That's what I'm looking forward to, that and the Chinese food buffet. If I can hit that for dinner, whew. I'll just, you know, eat a medium-sized lunch. Probably get a salad somewhere too. Make my girlfriend happy. Then I'm getting some vegetables. I don't know, might just get some veggies and dip and snack on that all night too while I'm staying at the hostel. Monday night. Actually, that sounds really good. Anyway, I'm gonna keep pushing the priest. I'm moving pretty quick. And yeah. That's about it, trying to get to the priest before the rain. Sorry the camera's all bouncy, but I'm just trying to move super quick. Climbing up the Spy Rock, I get a nice little gate. Not really a gate, just a fence now with a gap. Trail's pretty wide up here. I'm making good time, but I'm gonna sleep good tonight, that's for sure. Making my way towards the priest. Oh, that's a neat little spot. Oh. Make a pretty good time. Just gotta be careful not to fall. Spy Rock should be on the hill. It's covered by the trees. Or right there. I can't remember. I didn't even go out to it. I wish I did. But, oh, I just covered my leg in mud. I wish I went out to it. So it's a pretty good view. That's what I get for trying to push to the priest before the rain comes. And waiting for like 40 minutes at that shelter. Oh well. Is what it is. I'm just guessing, but this is Cache Hollow Road. Not 100%. And it's only 4:30. I left the shelter at 3:13. I've been pushing hard. I'm sweaty. And now I get to climb up a little climb, a couple hundred feet, then climb to the top of the priest. This is Virginia, 826. Priest is that way. Means I got 1.9 miles to go. It's just after 4:30. And it's an uphill climb. But every step gets me closer. It's 4:50. There's the sign for the Priest Mountain Wilderness. Well, the Priest Wilderness. Up I go. Time is 5:03, and I made it to the priest shelter. Well, the intersection. That puts me under 2 hours. It's over 3 miles an hour. I'll do the math here in a little bit when I get to the shelter. See exactly what time I hit the shelter.